This was one of the list of topics that I sent to Rami, about 10 topics, and he selected this one, so it must be an important here for you. The TKA market, as you know, that we are dealing with a very common disease, which is osteoarthritis. As you see here, the figures very high, and the number of knee replacement is increasing because of the increased population, elderly population. And if you look at statistics from US here, by 2030, the number is going to be more than 3.5 million knee replacement. The TKR impact on the economy is huge. This is one of the old papers from 2013, but it shows you how many knee replacement are there in patients, and many of these will require revision. So there is a huge burden on the economy. In Egypt here, this is a rough estimate that we have about 1 million patients needing TKR. The incidence of osteoarthritis is probably 3 times in Middle East and Far East compared with Caucasian. In addition to this, there is an accumulation of cases because of late presentation. So sometimes some of my patients have been advised to have knee replacement like 10 years prior to the surgery. So the question is, how many TKR needed worldwide? And can every country cope with the burden of knee replacement, or do we need to move patients and have medical tourists? This is the TKR prices worldwide. Be careful of these figures. I don't think it's very accurate and it's valuable. I got it from the internet, and I think it is different in different countries, as you can see here, but you can have higher or lower cost than what you see here. When we use computer-assisted surgery, definitely the price will go higher. There are many papers in the literature which show that TKR is a cost-effective procedure, but if you look at this paper here from 2017 in British Medical Journal, this is a cohort of more than 4,000 patient U.S. Patients who were followed up for 9 years. And it showed that, this procedure is not cost-effective at its current use because it is used for patients who are not severely affected. And the quoting figure here was a $14,000, that if the costs get less than that, then it will be cost-effective in certain type of patient who are with SF12 BCS scores. So the global medical tourism for TKR is different countries. If you look at Egypt, for example, we have a good industry for tourism, but we don't have one for medical tourism. In Thailand here, I heard that there is about 5 million patients who come for medical tourism, but few of them who have knee replacement. What I'm presenting today is that it's a personal initiative. It is not something that's popular in my country, but it's something that we have done in our center. On the left side here, you see this is our hospital. And I established the orthopedic department about 12 years ago where I did a model with a self-funded unit because we don't have funding for research. We don't have funding for postgraduate training. And in order to keep going, I had to find some sources of funding, and I made use of the assets we have in Egypt, the pyramids, the Nile, and I thought that medical tourism could give us some source of funding. Our center is accredited by some associations here, the CAIS Computer Assisted Surgery, because we use PSI in more than 90% of cases, especially for knee and uni replacement. We have a registry, and also we are recognized as a center for training ETLS. You will be very surprised by the figures here I'm quoting, that the cost of TKR can go down up to $1,000. When I do cases for a charity, this is basically the cost of the implant, and even slightly more than the cost of the implant. You will be surprised that these implants are the implants that are used here in Europe and U.S. simply because we don't have custom and we don't have taxes for implants. That's why the cost is probably maybe half of what is in US. So the average package here is about 4,000, which is small. That's in our center, but in other centers in Egypt, it may go up to 10,000. This package includes all what you see here, with the exception only of ICU. The procedures that are used is a primary TKA, Yoni, revision TKA, and also other arthroplasty. But we'll focus here on knee replacement. So the patient comes first on the day of arrival. They have the CT scan because we're using a PSI technique. And during this time, with the 3 days of waiting, they have a chance to go and see the pyramids, have a cruise in the Nile. And then by this time, the PSI template are ready. And this is the time when we can do the surgery. These are the packages, and the basic one, as I mentioned, is a 4,000. But this can increase, especially if you're having a tour or a medical tourism, and the highest where you can stay for 5 stars hotel for about 3 to 5 days prior to surgery during the preparation. And during this time, you can have altruistic visits. For some of you who are not familiar with the PSI, basically we do a CT scan, we do the planning, we select the size, we do alignment and everything, and then we software develop jigs that can be used, one for the femur and one for the tibia, and that's produced by 3D printers and then become ready for surgery after sterilization. Sometimes I don't use instruments at all, and at the bottom here, these are the basic instruments that I use during surgery. And other times, I can have this instrument as a standby, and as you can see here, this is a case of bilateral, and on the right side, this is a conventional instrument. On the left side, this is a PSI instrument, and that's what I basically used on the left side. So if you count these, these are just about 10 different pieces of instruments. In order to get medical tourism working, you have to reduce the cost. And reducing the cost, this does not mean that the hospital profits will be reduced. In fact, you can increase the hospital profit while you're reducing the cost. But the main question is how the PSI technique become less expensive than a standard TKR if we are going to have a more cost-effective model. To answer this question, here is just some analysis. If we compare between conventional PSI, you can see here that the implants is reduced. When I do PSI, I reduce the cost of the implant because I don't use the instruments. And also, we don't use the company rep who normally comes to hospitals. The hospital bill could be also reduced. Doctor's fees here is variable, can be increased or decreased, and recovery is also reduced. And here is an analysis. This is in Egyptian pounds. But you can see here the only extra cost for PSI is the CT scan, which is about $300, so that's not a big deal. And also the cost of the PCT, and again, that's not too much expensive. All the rest of items here, you can see that this is a saving on the PSI side as compared to conventional. And the same here, and it's more saving when you do bilateral, and the rate of bilateral is 90% in my practice. So we have 27 countries where patients came to have TKR or UKR surgery in our center. Thank you.